you don't like the nation. Envy has come up in your heart because the nation that you thought was dead and would never come back is up now and moving. Never fall again. God is clearing the deck. In the 60s, there were many black leaders we could look to. God has cleared the deck. I didn't ask for the job. I was running away from it. But I can't outrun God. I've never thought of myself as a leader. The only leader I know is the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. But he said he was making me to take his place among the people. And now I can't help myself. I'm on a course, and I can't give up. We have a rendezvous with destiny. Pharaoh is upset now because he's the only game in town. Jesse has bowed down. Hooks has bowed down. Jacobs has bowed down. The church has bowed down. The black leaders have bowed down. But we, the nation of Islam, will never bow our knee down to this true idea. Want us to apologize. Farrakhan, if you'd only apologize, apologize for what? Oh, them crackers, now I'm not afraid of you. You can't do nothing to me but what God permitted. If you make your move, my God is gonna kill you. Oh, I like to say that. I like to say that. A move and my God is gonna kill you. I'm not talking about no spook God. I'm not talking about your God. I'm talking about the God who came in person to make us his people, and he would be our God. The great man. The self-guided one who has power over all things. I thank him for his coming. Although I never saw his face, I thank him for raising up the Honorable Elijah Muhammad and empowering that man with wisdom unlike any wisdom I have ever heard before. I thank him for allowing me to come into the fold and to believe. And because I sincerely loved Allah and loved the messenger and loved the truth and loved you, God allowed me to put my music aside to become a preacher of truth. now with cassette and videotape. A revolution has started. All over the country. When I was at Michigan State, I said I'm a little fella with a trumpet. And the white boy put it in the paper the next day. He said, a little fella with a trumpet, but his people are listening. And that's what got white people frightened. I'm the first black man in a long, long time that the masses of black people are listening to. And since God is sitting down, those whom black people used to listen to, and raising up the one he wants them to listen to, then he's stirring up our enemies now. I want you to listen. Because our enemies do not want to submit to the God who came for them. And they want no part of the nation of Islam. But as the nation gets stronger and stronger, the government now has to attack the nation. Ultimately, we knew that they would do this. But it would be a moment of insanity. See, Pharaoh didn't attack Moses until he went totally crazy. And it was when he attacked Moses, Aaron, and the children of Israel, that's when Jehovah drowned him. Nation of Islam, quiet as is kept. Very beautiful group of people. We love our people.
Yes, sir.
We don't want to hurt our people.
Yes, sir.
We've tried everything we know to avoid conflict with our people.
Yes, sir.
And we will continue on that road.
Yes, sir.
But I ask you, in the name of Allah, don't let the white man incite you to come against the nation. Our defense is in the Quran.
Yes, sir.
Allah said he urged the hypocrites on against us so he could get a chance to kill them at our hands. Then Allah said, it was not you who slew them, it was I. See, God is no punk. God is not gonna play with you. And he's not gonna play with us. And he's not playing with those of us who say we believe in him. He's a real God, and he's angry. That's what is meant by the burning bush and the fire didn't consume it. A bush don't burn and is not consumed. He was on fire with rage against Pharaoh. And he wants to kill him. And every time Pharaoh would let the children of Israel go, God hardened his heart because he wanted to kill him. Master Farad Muhammad wants to kill America. And we are a dare. I'm like a dare. God is saying, yeah, that's my man. I dare you to touch him. I'll kill you. Now I'm going to show you. Brother said, I'm not playing. I'm not playing. You see, God will answer me. Bush got the CIA, the FBI, the IRS. He got all them letters,
yes, sir,
and all the power working to bring me in front of some court.
That's why the Christians sing the song, were you there when they crucified my Lord, because it wasn't my Lord's trial. It was yours, because that man walked among you. That man taught you. That man healed the blind, made the deaf hear, the dumb speak, and raised the dead to life. And yet it is time. The man that he said, pick up your bed and walk, he didn't show up. Lazarus that he had raised from the dead, he didn't show up. Peter ran away. James ran away. Thomas ran away. Matthew and Mark ran away.
The people held me in such high regard after hearing me till they just wanted to touch me. And I would like my children to say to me, we watched you all your life struggle. To see the rise of black people. Take your rest. We will carry on this mission.
We've been playing with Mark. Marketing Jesus like some product. But ain't nobody walking behind the man. You think by praising his name that that will get you into the kingdom? If you're not willing to walk the walk and keep his name out your mouth, because you're nothing but a lying hypocrite. Listen to me, God.
Through this criminal enterprise.
Walk through it. Walk through it.
I gotta say,
Sycamore.
See, these are criminals. You're dealing with a criminal government here. These are criminals in power. Maybe not in your eyes, but you can't see. Right now, you see your government as a tree, immovable, strong and powerful like a tree. You don't see, as you should see, their mannequins in the window of the Democratic store. They're dressed beautifully. They want you to try on democracy. Country don't give a damn about democracy. They're tricking you. This thing called democracy is a trick. Even right now, register to vote. Who the hell you gonna vote for? Stop. Go ahead. Who you voting for? Well, thank God, we can get rid of Bush. You mean you got hope in this corrupt political system? Do you really think that this corrupt political system is gonna really serve our needs? What the hell is wrong with you? That you're gonna sacrifice your children and your grandchildren on the false hope you've been took? Like Brother Malcolm said, you've been had, you've been hoodwinked, you've been bamboozled.
some spittle. Go ahead. I need to rub some spittle.